homily of the fifth Sunday in Ordinary Time, Year A. Our first reading is from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 58, verse 7 to 10. Our responsorial psalm is from Psalm 111. Our second reading is from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 2, verse 1 to 5. And the gospel is according to Saint Matthew, chapter 5, verse 13 to 16. The theme of the homily is salt to the earth and light of the world. In a world characterized by individualism, egocentrism, and materialistic consumerism, weak social bonds, abandoning the weakest, and considering some as useless, Pope Francis insists, the many situations of inequality, poverty, and injustice are signs not only of a profound lack of fraternity, but also of the absence of a culture of solidarity. He said this in the 2014 edition of the World Day for Peace. This message reminds us of the concluding prayer of Pope John Paul II, used in the encyclical Sollicitudo Rei Socialis on social concern in 1987. Father, you have given all peoples one common origin, and your will is to gather them as one family in yourself. Fill the hearts of all with the fire of your love and the desire to ensure justice for all their brothers and sisters. By sharing the good things you give us, may we secure justice and equality for every human being, end all division, and build a human society of love and peace. These and many other churches' social teachings show how today's first reading is applied. As Christians, we are challenged to cultivate a solidarity culture. For our Christian light to shine in the world today, for our prayers to be heard, Isaiah does not mince words in insisting that we must help the poor. In the face of suffering in the world, several world summits have been organized in very comfortable areas, and many philosophies and sophistries have been made and proposed. After such meetings, statistics on the number of poor in the world are given. These do not solve the problems because the poor are getting poorer every day. Like Paul in the second reading, solidarity with the poor should not end with an oratory or a philosophy. Christ reminds us of a fundamental truth. We should be the salt to the earth and the light of the world. Our presence in the world must bring hope and a chance for others to see goodness and notice love. A love many may have been longing for, but had not been able to see. Salt had two purposes in the Middle East of the first century. Because of the lack of refrigeration, salt was used to preserve food, especially meat, which got bad in a hot environment. Believers in Christ, therefore, preserve the world from the evil inherent in our society. Second, salt was used as now as a flavor enhancer. In the same way, salt enhances flavor of the food it seasons, the followers of Christ enhance the flavor of life in the world. Light dispels darkness. Therefore, the presence of light in darkness is something unmistakable. The presence of Christians in the world must be like light in the darkness, not only in the sense that the truth of God's word brings light to the darkened heart of sinful men, according to John chapter 1 verse 1 to 10, but also in that our good deeds must be evident for all to see. We cannot be salt and light and be blind to those who are suffering around us. It is only when we remain focused on Christ and obey Him that we can remain the salt and the light of the world. And may Almighty God bless and protect you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.